something about it now. Oh, I know something. Right, we'll just hold on a little second to see if anyone joins in, and then we will get cracking with the session. Okay. We'll just give everyone a minute, a chance to join on and see if anyone joins in. So if anyone is in, there's one person there I can see. Just make sure you've got a little bit of room to work in. So I've just got a mat here. I'm going to do my work on the mat. I don't need much more space than that, to be honest with you. Right, so it's 11. Let's get started now anyway. So what we're going to do is we're going to run through a strength and conditioning session based around running. So there's a lot more people going out running and walking and getting out and about with the restrictions and things. So this session is really going to be based around how you can improve your mobility, your flexibility and things as a runner, and how it's going to protect your muscles and your ligaments and your joints for when you actually go out and do your runs and you're going out and pounding the pavements, if you will, and you're not putting too much pressure and strain on these different parts of your body. So the session, what we're going to do is, can't really see that board behind me, but it's got five different exercises. I'm going to take you through the exercises, and then we're going to do three or four sets of each exercise. All right. So like I say, you'll only need a little bit of space where you've got a mat that you're going to, the movements aren't going to be too vigorous. We're not going to be moving around too much, and it's just going to be based around strength and engagement of your different joints and ligaments for runners, really. So first of all, this just, I'll just let you know that it's not just for runners. This doesn't have to be for people that only go out running and pounding and that kind of thing. It's excellent for your mobility and your movement around your hips, your hip flexors, your ankles, your joints and things that you're not using as much if you're at home doing all these online classes and what have you. So, right, okay. I'll take you through them first of all. So like anything, we should have done a little bit of a warm-up before. So I won't take you through a warm-up, but I'll just show you what we're going to do. So the first one, we've got split squats. So a split squat is where we're going to be starting in a split position. So our legs are nice and wide. We can go up onto our toes for our back leg, and our front leg is nice and planted. But we're going to be making sure our hips are forward, our chest is forward, our head's up. And all we're going to do is we're going to lower that back knee down to the ground and back up again. So we're engaging the hips. We're keeping our core and our back nice and straight and nice and controlled. And we're going down and returning back up. So we're going to go 10 on each side. All right, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, nice and controlled, no movement. All you're doing is lowering them hips down to the ground, that knee down to the ground. And again, on the other side, we're going to go for 10. 2. So making sure that front knee is just about over your ankle. So you don't want to be going too far forward or too far back. It's about a 90 degree angle, as you can see. 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, we'll have a little bit of a rest in between each set. So we're going to do four sets of that one, all right? I'll just show you another way that we can make it a little bit more difficult. If you want to add weights and introduce weights and you want to put a bit more emphasis on the hip power and the hip strength, then you can just have weights that you're going to dangle down either side, and it just puts a little bit more work on them hip flexors, them hips. Also, if you've got no weights, it might be a good idea if you've got something that's raised off the floor, all we're going to do is we're going to raise that back leg. So raising that back leg just puts a little bit more strength, a little bit more work and power on that front leg. So your balance and mobility is key on this one. Again, it's just raising that a little bit higher makes it that little bit more difficult. All right, so I'm going to go for set number two. So get yourself ready. Let's split your legs. And let's go again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. So you should really feel it on that hip, that front hip, that front thigh. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. There we go. Right. Just give it a little shake off. You'll be feeling it. Right, and then front hip flexors. So grab yourself a drink. I'm going to turn it around now so you can see the front on view. Let's have a look. All right. So this one, remember, we've got to have that little slight gap in between your legs. You don't want to be crossing them legs over or having your legs too wide. So you want to keep a nice sturdy balance about shoulder width apart. All right, let's go for round number three. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Very important to keep your breath, control your breath on this as well when you're doing your exercise. Make sure you are breathing, you're not holding your breath, and it's not too, you don't want you passing out or anything like that. 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. Right, very good. We've got one more set of them to do, and then we'll move on to the next exercise. So I don't know who's actually going out running at the moment and doing a lot of running activities, but it's very important because you are constantly pounding, putting a lot of pressure, it's putting a lot of strain on your hip flexors, your lower back muscles, your joints and your knees and things. So doing these exercises just allows you to get a little bit more strength. It allows you to get a little bit more control over them, really, and it helps you. But when you are going out running, you're going to start to improve. You'll get faster times. You'll get longer distances. It's just going to help you in your recovery and things. So let's go for set number four. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, and switch it over to the other side. Last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, very good. Should really start to feel it in them front of the hips and your hip flexors and them ones. Right, exercise number two. I'll show you this one. Just point this down a little bit. So this one's going to be the hip bridge. Okay, so I'll lie it to the side. So this one, we're starting down on a mat or on the floor, whatever you've got. So this one is where we're engaging our glutes, so at the back, your bum muscles. So all we're going to do is we're going to raise them glutes up, clench them, keep them nice and tight, and then just lower again back to the ground, okay? So we're going to go for 12 of these. 1,
2, 3. Again, nice and controlled. Feel them muscles engaging right around your core muscles, your glute muscles, your quad muscles. You got that thing that I've been looking for. 10, 11, and one more, 12. There we go. So we're going to do 3 sets of this one. All right. So as I say, very important for your lower body, your glutes, your hip flexors. It's all about engagement. So before you go out for these runs, it's good to get all these muscles ready and engaged for them. So you want to be aiming to do these around 2 or 3 times a week, just to make sure your muscles are engaged before you are going out for these runs. And it just helps in the long run on your, on the toll it takes on your body, really, for running. All right, let's go again. Set number 2. Remember to keep them feet planted on the floor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There we go. One more set of these to do. If you're feeling any aches and pains, any strains or anything, don't push yourself. Don't do it. Just do it as much as your body will allow you to, okay? If you start to feel an injury, you've tore something, then it's just going to make it worse if you do carry on. All right then, hip bridge, let's go. Number 3, third and final one. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Very good. So again, on this one, you can put the weight, a little bit of weight on resistance on it to make it a little bit more difficult. If you've got a bar, it's good to have a bar running across. If you've just got like a small weight, like a dumbbell or something, you can just add that little bit extra weight onto your stomach, your abs, so it puts more stress, more work on your glutes and your hip flexors to get that up, okay? So that is if you want to progress it onto the next one. Right, this one, I'm probably going to fall over doing this one, but this one's quite difficult to do. It's all about balance and it's all about mobility. It's all about controlling yourself and controlling your own body. So this one's called the arabesque. Okay, so this is all about putting everything on one leg and using that one leg to control yourself. Again, it's going to make them hip flexors work a lot. And it's all about just controlling yourself and making sure you don't fall over. So, right, this one, we're going to go up onto one leg. We're going to raise our arms in front of us and our leg behind. Okay, so you want to try and get as horizontal as you can on this one. So nice and controlled, making sure you're not falling over. We're going to go for 8 reps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, and swap it over to the other side. So this is where you're going to start to feel if you've got an imbalance in your legs and your hips. So this one is going to test you, really. See if your left side's as good as your right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very good. So like I say,
you'll start to feel an imbalance, all right? It's important in running, especially, that you even that imbalance out. Otherwise, you are going to pick up injuries if you're putting too much load on one side as compared to the other. So these exercises will help balance them out as well. All right. So all we're doing is three rounds of this one again. So I'll just show you with this next round how you can weight it as well and put a little bit more work on them hip flexors. So what you're going to do is you're going to dangle one weight down to the ground, but continue the movement with your foot and your hands at the foot, okay? So just need that little bit more stability when you've got a weight in there. All right, so let's go for round number two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Right, you might feel your lower back really tensing up when you're doing this as well. It's good to get that clench when you get that leg back in your lower back as well. That's going to improve your strength in your lower back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There's round number two. Very good. Yeah, like I said, the lower back's really important when you're running. It takes a lot of pressure, it takes a lot of pounding, and the lower back muscles take a lot of the impact and a lot of the force. So doing these as well are excellent for improving them lower back muscles, going into your glutes as well. All right, we're almost there. One more set of this one, all right? Let's go for number three. Let's go nice and controlled. One, you'll feel that you can control it a lot better the more you practice this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Very good. There we go. There's round number three done. Well done. Get yourself a drink. So you're looking for all five of these exercises to take you about 30 minutes, all right? So I'm sure you've got 30 minutes in the day, if you are a runner, to squeeze them in two or three times a week, maybe. So the next one we're going to do is side plank. So I'll just lower this down slightly for you. All right, this one can be quite difficult, and it might feel quite uncomfortable at first. But the more you practice it, the more you do it, the easier it'll get. And we're going to go for 30 seconds on each side. If you can't quite do 30 seconds, just go as long as you can and then stop wherever you can. And then if you can do 30 seconds and you find it too easy, I'll show you a slight moderation to it as well. All right? So all we're going to do is we're going to keep our hips nice and square, going forward, nice and parallel. Our legs nice and parallel, and we're going to keep a nice straight spine all the way down, all right? And we're gonna hold it for 30 seconds. So I'll just set a timer. Right, we're ready, let's go. 30 seconds, that's now. Just
Try and keep that form. You might start to shake a little bit, but just try and hold it. Ten seconds left. Keep it going. Well done. And time there. Well done. So we're going to go both sides. 30 seconds on each side. And then we're going to go for three sets of this one as well. Okay. When we're ready, let's go on the opposite side. Important to keep that aligned. You'll start to feel it in the side that's underneath you. That's where all the pressure's going. So it's really good for your obliques and then hips and then the ligaments right down. Your inside side that you're working on. All right. 5 seconds left. 2, 1. Timer. Woo. Get a sweat on after that one. Very good. All right. We've got one more exercise after this. We've got two more sets of this one, and then we've got one more exercise, and we're done. So I think we're on time for about 30 minutes as well, which is good. Right, I'll show you one now that's going to make it a little bit more difficult if you want to improve in the future and keep progressing on this exercise, okay? So we're going to go for 30 seconds. Are you ready? 30 seconds starts now. And it starts, there we go. So if you want to make it a little bit more difficult, you can actually try and lift them top arm and legs up, all right? You can try and keep it in the air if you want to, very difficult. Or you can just continuously move it up and down, all right? Just try it, it puts that little bit of control over you. It's very difficult when it starts really working. These obliques. Okay, time. 30 seconds there. Very good. And the opposite side. Going up. Oh, forgot to start the timer. Let's go. Halfway there. Keep it going. Remember, keep them hips up, keep them aligned. Keep that spine nice and aligned. 3, 2, 1, and time there. Well done. There's two sets, one more set to go. Grab yourself a drink if you need a drink. You want to be aiming for about 60 seconds in between these exercises. Just give yourself a little bit of a break and then straight into the next one. I might be rushing it a little bit just because of the video, but yeah, you want to be aiming for about 60 seconds in total. Right, round number 3. Are we ready? Going to go on the other side. Let's go up. Nice and controlled. Keep your breathing. Breathing's really important in these exercises. Well done. Keep it going. 5 seconds left. And time there. Well done. Let's swap it over to the other side. This is the last one. And then we're on to the last exercise. Right, you ready? Let's go. Nice and controlled. Keep it going. Well done. 10 seconds left. Important to keep your form. As soon as that form starts to drift out, you might want to stop. You don't want to be doing poor form. You want to be keeping the form if you can. There's time. Very good. Well done.
So that's four exercises done. We're on to our last exercise now. So for this one, you can do it on the floor if you want to. It's better if you've got something that you're going to step up onto. So it can be a step, it can be your stairs in your house. It can be any raised edge, really. So it can be a door, a doorway. It might be, I don't know, you might have a little raised doorway or something in your house. But I'm going to use a step. I'll just get the step down. So I'm going to use this aerobic step. So we've worked on our hips, we've worked on our glutes, we've worked on our core, we've worked on everything around this lower back core area, your hip flexors. All right, so this one now is going to engage our calves. So our calf muscles, and all we're going to do is we're going to do calf raises. So you want your foot just slightly on the step, slightly off the step, all right? So your toes are just going to be raising. The reason we use a step is so we can go a little bit deeper when we come down to the bottom of the movement, okay? When we go up to the top of the movement and then we return back down. If you're on a floor, you can only come to that movement, that place, really. If you've got a step or something where it's raised, you can go that little bit further down, okay? Engaging your full muscle, engaging them ligaments a little bit more, okay? So if you need something to lean on, it might be good to have a banister or something. So what we're going to do, raise it down, and we're going to go calf raises. So we're going to go 12 calf raises. Ooh, control and balance is very good on this one. All right, good. So nice and controlled. One, two. Ooh, there we go. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12. Really good to have something to hold on to, because I nearly fell down. All right, so if you've got something, maybe just a wall or something, it's not assisting you from doing more work, it's just assisting you from falling over, all right? So it could be even this, something like this. You know it's not going to fall over. You know you can just hold on to get that little bit of stability, okay? Still doing the same movement, but it's just there for you if you need it, okay? So I'm going to use it so I don't fall. Right, ready? We're going to go for four rounds of this one. So that's one round done. Four rounds of 12, okay? Let's go. One, two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Very good. Nice, slow, restricted movements. All right, very good for your soleus muscles, all your calf muscles and your ankle movements. So your ankle mobility and things. So when you're doing these running sessions, your ankles, you might be on uneven surfaces. It's not always like a treadmill where we're running on a nice even surface, all right? When you're outside and you're running, that ankle mobility is very important. So movements like this as well, engage that ankle mobility, as does things like the split squat and then movements as well. Two sets to go. Right, we ready? Let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12. There we go. One more set to do and we're done. All right. After these exercises, I expect you to do your own stretches. So stretch off, give yourself a little bit of a stretch on your calves, your quads, all your leg muscles, all right, your hamstrings, and maybe a bit of hip mobility, okay? Just give yourself a little bit of a stretch around them areas, just to make sure that you're not aching too much tomorrow, all right? Right.
Are we ready? Round number four. Let's get back on our step. And then let's go for round number four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Very good. Excellent. 30 minutes bang on there. Well done. That's it. So that is our strength and conditioning for your improvement of your running and your just your walking, your overall getting out and about strength and your mobility and flexibility and your movement around your joints and things. So well done. And next session, we will hopefully do something a little bit different. I'll try and mix it up a little bit. But tomorrow, Bronte's got another session, so we hope to see you all then. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.